In this video, you're gonna learn how to set up a list building funnel. So I'm gonna show you step by step how to do this in Thrive Architect. Hi, I'm Hanne from Thrive Teams, and here in this video, we're really gonna go deep into how to set up a list building funnel. Every business needs to collect leads, and the way to do this is to give away some kind of free report in return for an email address, and that's exactly what we are going to do here. You will learn how to set up your lead generation landing page, how to set up a confirmation page, and how to set up a thank you download page. And you will send a free PDF to your subscribers. We will not go into detail about how to create this PDF or what exactly should be in this PDF, because we have a lot of resources that explain that. So I'll simply link to them underneath this video. So now let's dive right in. Let's start building this funnel. Now, the very first page that you need is the lead generation page. So what you will do is go to your WordPress dashboard and add a new page. Now, you can give this page a name that is logical for you, because this is not going to show. We are going to change the URL a bit because we want this to look good. This will be the URL of our lead generation landing page. Now, let's edit this with Thrive Architect. To create a good-looking lead generation landing page, I'm simply going to load one of the templates that is included in Thrive Architect. So go to Page Setup, and from here, change landing page templates. Now here we can choose from a whole bunch of landing pages, and I'm going to go for the elementary. So let's pick the one-step lead generation one. Choose this template. This gives us a good looking lead generation landing page or a list building landing page, but we want to customize this to give it more like a branded look. So from here, the very first thing that we can do is click on this background section and change the color. So one of my brand colors is this green. So we'll apply this. And then of course you can change the image to make it your cover of your ebook. And then maybe we can make this image a little smaller. And we can center align this image and then give it a bit more of a margin. This already looks pretty good. We're gonna change this button also. But first of all, let's talk about the headline. The headline is one of the most important elements here on your page. And that headline has to convince people to sign up for your email list. So you have to try to arouse curiosity so that people actually want to know what's in the free ebook. So in this case, it could be something like, discover 11 high-fat foods your doctor would never tell you about, but that you actually need in a healthy diet. And then in the subline, you are going to explain people how they can get this free report. So be super clear about it. Something like sign up below or put your email below and download this report immediately. Now, this title is a bit big in this column, so I would probably like change the column width a little bit so that it takes up a little bit more space. And now we can customize the lead generation form. For that, click on the element. And from here, you can see connect a form to service, and that's something that we will do later on. So this is how you will connect it to your email service. But first of all, let's edit the form elements. So click on the edit form elements, and then now let's, for example, click on this button. As a text, we could put download the report. And let's also change the button color. Now, if you want to add an effect, as you can see here, there's an effect on hover, and so you probably want to change this one to also be more of your brand color, then you can go into state. Here you can see state default, and let's go to the hover state. So from here, we can also click on change the color. So maybe this is like the second of my brand color, so I'll apply this one. And now what happens when somebody hovers over it, it will change from green to this dark blue. So we can exit the state. Let's already save what we've been doing. And as you can see now on hover, it changes the color. Now, if we want to change something about the input fields, again, simply click on the input field And you can then change everything about this. So if you want a different border color or maybe no border or whatever, you can change this. What you can also do is drag elements next to each other. So imagine that you want this more to be like this, like enter your name, enter your email, or maybe you don't even want to ask for a name, and that's something that you will be able to change when you connect to your email provider. So we'll change that later on. But for now, let's make it like this, and it's just save and close. Now we can preview our lead generation landing page. But as you can see, it looks exactly the same, and that's one of the big advantages of Thrive Architect. Now, the next page that we need is a confirmation page. Now, you will only need this confirmation page if you actually use a double confirmation opt-in process. A double opt-in means that people actually will get an email on which they have to confirm that they want to sign up for this list before actually being able to receive this free report. Now, in some countries, this is obligatory, and in other countries, you can choose if you want to apply a double or a single opt-in. But in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do the double opt-in, because then the single one is even simpler. Let's make a confirmation page. Again, add a new page and call this confirmation. Now, what's important with this page is that you actually ask Google and other search engines not to index this page. And for that, we are using a free plugin that's called Yoast SEO. And you can simply go into the advanced settings and here ask no index and no follow. Go to edit with Thrive Architect. Again, we are going to go to the page setup, change landing page templates. Go to the set that we were using, so the elementary, and choose the elementary email confirmation page. So as you can see, this is one of the big advantages of using landing page sets. You can be sure that everything in the set looks exactly the same. So your subscriber will not be lost when they arrive on the confirmation page. Let's quickly change some things on this page again. So I would go back to the background section, change this background to be the same green as on the other page. And of course, we're also going to change the image. So you can just click on the image and then here pick the change image button and make this your cover image. Let's just center align this, give this a little bit more margin. So this looks better. Now, I would probably also change the font color of this text so that it matches my brand color. And then here you can see that in the first step, you indicate people to go to their email inbox and find a message sent from your name. So here you would put, in our case, Thrive Themes, and then the subject line. Now, that's it. This is our confirmation page. We can save this. And we can simply check. I forgot to show it on the sign up page, but you can always check if this looks good on tablet and if this looks good on mobile. So from here you can see this still looks good. The title became smaller, so that's okay. And now we just have to set up one more page, and that is the actual download page. So for that, let's go back into our WordPress dashboard and create a new page. Now, for this page, we want to avoid that people find this page. So maybe on the URL, you can simply add some random numbers on it so that it makes it more difficult to find this page. And of course, we will do the same with the Yoast SEO plugin. We will go into the advanced settings and we will ask not to index, so no index. And you can also no follow this page. So that means that nobody will just stumble upon it in some search engine. So let's save this again. Edit with Thrive Architect and load our download landing page. So from the same set, let's pick the download page. Now we're quickly gonna customize this again. So again, our green color here, and then on the button, we can also change the button color. And this is the same. You can change the hover of the button. So let's go to the state here, the default state. Let's pick the hover state and let's make this the dark color, apply. Let's exit the state. So now we have our hover effect and we want this to be the same image. So change image and make this our e-cover. and make this a little smaller. Now here, what you want to do is you want to make sure that the image and the start download button are linked to your PDF. And for this, the simplest way is when you go into your media, you go to your library, and from here, you can go to add new, select a file, and so you're gonna select your PDF file. Now this PDF file is hosted on your own website, and you, when you click on it, you can see here that you get a URL link, and so this URL ends with .pdf, so that's the link that you want. Let's copy this one, and then when you go to your image, you can go here into image link, and we will just put the PDF link in here, and we will do the same with the button. So when you click on the button, you see here the button link, and let's also put the PDF in there. Now let's save this and let's preview. So now, as you can see, this is linked and you can click on it and this will open the PDF. Now, same will happen when you click on the button. So this will open the PDF report. And that's exactly what we want on this download page. When we go back to our editing, you can see that here we are actually announcing a new bonus. And that's something that you can do to actually really wow your new subscribers. And that's giving them something that they even didn't expect at all. So this could be like maybe a video, or this can be, yeah, the unannounced bonus. You could also use this thank you page. So you can actually have a message in video. So imagine that you have like a little thank you for signing up video. In that case, you can simply search here in the elements, choose the video element, drag it in there, and then from your YouTube account, you can open any video. Now, this is not a video that's a welcome video, but it's just to show you. So here you can insert a video in YouTube and then in the URL. So let's put this URL in here. And as you can see, it immediately loaded the video. We can even change the style a little bit. So you maybe like make this like as if it's a computer. So that puts like a monitor around it, or maybe like a tablet, or just like a frame. So write a black frame around it so we can apply this. And in the advanced settings, what you can do is you can hide the title of this video and you can hide the logo and also hide the related. So that means that at the end of the video, people will not see the related videos that you usually see in YouTube. So I suggest that you do this for any video that you host on YouTube that is on this type of page. And maybe like this is pretty big, so I would probably like make this more like 800 pixels or something. So make this a little smaller video. But let's imagine that this is your thank you message for people, and that you say like, hey, thank you so much for signing up. You can find the report just below. Click on the report, click on the download link. And I also have like this special unannounced bonus for you. And then you can explain people what this is. So this could also be like, hey, you can sign up for the free Facebook group or something similar. Now, if you don't need this, you don't have to, you can just simply click on this element and delete it. So now it's not there anymore. And this would be our thank you for signing up page. So let's save everything here. Now we have all our necessary pages set up, let's connect this with the email provider. So first of all, to connect your email provider to Thrive Teams, the easiest way is to do this through API. So when you go to your Thrive dashboard, you can see here that you have API connections. So manage connections, and then you will be able to add your emails. Now I will link to a tutorial for every possible email service so that you can find how to do this for your own, but it's really simple. You add it and then you select yours, and you will need some information like an API key. But like I said, we have tutorials for each one of them. Once you connect it, you can see here, I already have ActiveCampaign, so the email provider I will use that's connected through API, which means that now when I go to my pages, and let's sort by date, when I go to my signup page that I can from here edit with Thrive Architect, I will now be able to connect this email form with my email provider. So when I click on this, like I said, here you have the connect form to service. Let's click on this. And you can pick the API connections. So here you can see all the API connections I have on my site. Usually you will only have one because this is a test site. I have multiple accounts. So let's pick Active Campaign. And then here you will see that you have mailing lists and that you can also choose the form. Now, this is something that you will need if you use the double opt-in. If you use a single opt-in, you will not use this form. But if you need to send people a confirmation email, then you will use forms. This is how it works in ActiveCampaign. Every email provider is a little bit different. But so if you go to ActiveCampaign and to forms, you can add a new form. Let's call this healthy food. And from here, you want people to subscribe to a list. And so this would be our Thrive Teams list. And now you can completely ignore all the ugly styling because we don't need it. But you would have to go into options. And then here, the form actions, you actually have opt-in options. And as you can see here in the edit form actions, you can choose if you want to put an opt-in confirmation in place, yes or no, and then you can actually edit and preview this. So this is how you would go about this in ActiveCampaign, but in other email providers, this might work differently. So here in our case, we would use Thrive Teams. I will just reload it because I just created the form. And then from here, you could choose your healthy foods. Here we go. And you can even add tags if you have an email service that actually allows tags. So in this case, let's just continue. Now, like I said, here you can actually decide whether or not you want to ask for the name of your contact. There are studies that have shown that the more fields you ask people to fill out, the lower your opt-in rate will be. But it can be a good idea to ask for a name because then you can actually personalize your emails. So this is really your preference, whether you personalize emails or not. If you don't personalize emails, I suggest you don't ask for a first name. Here, if you don't want to ask for it, let's just click on the delete button. So here on this little bin. And if you want to add it back, you can now select it back and add it back again. And here you can enter the text that people will see on your opt-in form. So enter your first name, for example. Let's click on next. Now, the reason why we actually created all the pages before connecting the opt-in form is exactly for the post opt-in actions, because now we will be able to redirect to a custom URL. What this means is that we can redirect to a thank you page, or in this case, to a confirmation page. So here you can search on your site. So here I can have the confirmation, high fat, healthy, the page, and I can save this. So this means that now when somebody signs up to this opt-in form, you can see here, they will be signed up to my ActiveCampaign account, and the ActiveCampaign account will send a confirmation email. Now from here, when somebody clicks on the download the report, they will go to the confirmation page. So you have to make sure that in your account here, in your email account, when you choose here the confirmation action, it's really important that you choose redirect to URL, because here we want people to direct to our download page. So let's take our download URL and put it in here. So now this means that when somebody signs up from our opt-in page, so from this sign-up page, they will be sent to the confirmation page. And then when they go to their email, they click on their email, they will be sent to the download page. Now let's test the whole process. So I open this page in an incognito window. I can enter my first name. Now, as you can see, as soon as we click on the download link, we are sent to this confirmation page. And then in the email, you will see a button that's like confirm my subscription. And from here, when you click on this button, you go to the download page. And when you click on one of the download buttons on the image or on the button, you get your free PDF report. So this is how you can build in just a few minutes a list building funnel with Thrive Architect. I hope you liked this video, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below.